I think all the guys in the band are dope. And I don't think they really go to church or anything, but it's still fun to play music.
Now I know how people smoke with and not take it away, they have glasses. So I just get in my eye.
That's the interface. This got four inputs, so now when we do like rough recordings, we can just record. Well, we can
check. Now not we can hold a cigarette and play it.
We can do like four inputs and stuff. So it's like we could set it up on stage, like a kick, a snare, like two old men.
Terry and Ty are a little bigger than me and Dryden. Dryden's a little bigger than Dryden. And I'm kind of back to myself.
I'll be the switch she turns on. She'll be mine too. I get off. I'll be the fuse that she blows.
I'm Terry Corso, and I play guitar in the band, and I'm building a deck in my backyard right now.
I'm Mike, and I play the drums.
I'm Ty, and I play bass.
Dryden, singing.
Wait.
What's that? Oh, my name's Dryden Mitchell Vera, Vera Mitchell. I sing.
I'll be the switch she turns on. She'll be my two. I get up.
So I found a piece of and made a tie for it. We're gonna do a little photo shoot. This very well might be the friggin' most terrible photo ever. Well, for one, because it's of Terry, and two, because I took it.
Pencil fighting is where you fight pencils against each other.
Like, my pencil is bigger than yours, I'll bet you I'll break it.
Usually, like, it usually works best when you have, like, the NFL football pencils, and you take your favorite team, and you just, like, you know?
So if it was like Dolphins-Rams, then Dolphins would obviously just conquer.
Well, the Dolphins would have got beat twice.
The Rams.
By the mighty Ram right here.
Wow, dude.
Oh, shit.
Sound good?
That I thought it was
dope.
Dude, don't film me, man. I don't like to be filmed. Like, I get all like subconscious and stuff when I get on camera. Like, I lose like what I want to say in front of the camera and stuff. Like, I don't like to be filmed, dude. I just think it's like I get all nervous. You know, I'm not really a vain kind of guy. I just don't like to be filmed on camera, man. I just think it's wrong. Like, we're in a rock band and stuff, like a really big one. And I don't like to be filmed, man. I just think it's wrong. Like, some bands are like, hey, check me out. Like, hey, check me out.
I like you. You tell me. Cosmos continue.
The first single is a song called These Days. It's actually an older song and kind of got morphed in pre-production. And it's pretty heavy driving. It's pretty like straight up rock and roll song. Like it's just got a good hooky chorus. I think it's like on a first time listen, it's very like, it's just very gettable. Robert and Dean are good people,
dude,
man.
Dude, they're funny. We fit in right with them, man. They're like, we have the same sense of humor. I think they're just a little older and have better stories than us, you know?
You ever goggle with balls?
And I ended up somehow on the porch with Robert and Dean, and all three of us had acoustics, and we were playing Stone Temple Pilots songs. And I was kind of learning them as we go along and stuff, and I just kind of had to stop for a minute and go, what the doing here, you know, like this is weird.
Because you didn't know the song?
Yeah. I was like, I don't need to be here.
Recording this record was a lot different. The producers were just so hands-on with this record, as opposed to the last record was kind of all in our hands, you know, and I think everyone kind of knew what they wanted to do a little more clearly, and we had a lot more time to do pre-production on this record and really get the songs worked out the way they were intended to be, you know.
I'm making a scarf. I'm knitting it myself.
Your camera sucks.
Your camera
sucks.
Wait, let me have that again. I just want a cigarette.
Dude, learn how to sing.
I'm learning.
Learn how to write some good lyrics, too. Peace. Lyrics.
Dude, I'm an insecure guy.
She's all mine.
Yeah, that's good.
Dude, I'm an insecure guy. You can't be saying that.
We'll be right back. It's crashed like semi-trailer. Maybe I spend my off time without you. It seems like we need our own space. And all this time I chased you away. Did not feel good unless you stay, stay, stay. And all this time I waste you away. Simply to catch back. You wanted, baby, and I don't blame you falling backwards. No one's ever quite confused you this way, and all this time we wasted away. We don't feel good unless we're crazy, and all this time it chased you. Thanks, guys.
I think my favorite song on the record is a song called Tia Lupe. It's got like a real super authentic, ethnic, kind of Latin feel. And the song is about a girl who traps a moth and builds a kind of a cage for this moth. And there's a light in the cage. And the moth's kind of attracted to the light. And but the moth doesn't know that the light could, like, eventually will kill it, tire it out, and kind of compared that to like a love relationship. If you're in with somebody you're not meant to be with, like, they can kind of drain you the same way, you know? Anything should take advantage. this album feels a little more serious when I hear it, but I don't know. We went through a bad accident and stuff, and maybe that's just part of what makes me think that the songs on here are a little more serious than the first one. Our bus accident happened in Spain on the way to Portugal.
Right? 2 o'clock in the morning, and on our way to Portugal, and we didn't make it.
Mike stepped up to grab something, and that's when the big boom happened. It was a scary time, man. I couldn't even move my feet, my fingers. We love to break the season. The bus just kind of stopped.
It hit a big truck.
Yeah, I couldn't move for a while, and then I could. I broke my neck, my second vertebrae, and had to wear a halo brace. I got these cute little scars and some more scars, and had to go through some surgery where they put some screws and wire in my neck and just try and get better each day. See why you cry,
see why you save. Yo, man, I came to do the tracks. These that I can't sing. But I'll take any one of them ghetto style on the b-ball court, you know what I'm saying? Oh damn, did that go in?
I never thought that you'd find out I did that. I was so scared that you leave, so I hit that.
If there's any jokes going on, it's usually not like on
any of us. Try and steer clear of each other.
Like there was the tree incident in our on our bus. Like everyone pretty much got hit except for the band members. Here though was Mike and Dryden that were doing the shenanigans of throwing trees into everyone's bunk. Be the switch she turns on. She'll
be my two. We're in Japan now, taking pictures like crazy.
Take a picture.
Snap my picture. Snap my picture. Take my picture.
Seeing kids appreciate what we're doing and seeing us after the shows, you know, just giving their love or saying they appreciate the music that we play. And sometimes I'll run into kids that, you know, oh, I learned how to play this song of yours. And it's just,
and
that's the coolest
say,
part of being on
did
tour.
You learn it right?
Not a short guess, we're coming on with us. Dude, I don't even remember doing like half the stuff that's on the DVD. Like, it's fun that it's documented and it's there, you know? Just silly stuff when there's nothing else to do.
Dryden is naked again. He's coming to your bus.
She traps a velvet moth between her harmless hands, then builds an atrium to perch on her nightstand.
We had a lot of just drunken fun, drunken behavior, naked beer bongs, and
midget slapping. I mean, not us slapping midgets, but them slapping.
Slapping
us.
Midgets.
Like, wait. Harder.
Go ahead and put the mic up real close.
My favorite song on the record is a song called Capuchow. All right, no, it's not.
1,000
days. 1,000 days, yeah, 1,000 days. Just because it has a kick-ass bass line. My favorite song on the record is is Never Met. That was a song that used to be another song, and we took out the best part of the song and made this just amazing song out of it. But my probably my favorite song on the record is what else is on the record?
I know you.
No friends, no problem. Whamco's play with yourself balls.
Kids won't hang out because you're a nerd. No worries, you can play catch with yourself.
Friends are overrated. Thanks, play with yourself balls.